Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss a topic of Assam history. In Assam and Bengal, there is a class of people known as Huyas. Now, who are the Huyas? There is no specific mention in history on the origin of the Huyas in Assam. The word Huya means a landlord. Word is synonymous with the Persian equivalent word Jamindar and Sanskrit word Bhumika. The Huyas did not have any ethnic basis. They were only a class of people. Huyas rose into considerable prominence following the disintegration of the ancient kingdom of Kamrupa. Initially, they exercised their power in the region between the Dikrai and the Barnadi on the north bank of the Brahmaputra and in the Kapilivile and eastern part of Kamrupa on the south. Towards the later part of the Chandya's reign, they started asserting themselves in western Assam also. Gradually, they became so important factor in the politics of that time that some Huyas like Arimatra and Niladhaja even exercised sovereign power. Though most of the Huyas in Assam were Kayasthas, references to Brahmanas and Daivagya Huyas are also come across. The tradition of Barafuya is common to both Bengal and Assam. The Bengal Huyas came into the arena of politics in the declining period of the Pala region and under the Sena rulers. They were at best bloated jomindars. Amongst them were Barendra Brahmins, Kayasthas and Muslims. Though Muslims, Huyas are very rare in Assam. They became very powerful between the setting of Afghan kingship and rising of Mughal Empire in Bengal. Some of them find mention even in Akbarnama and the Ain-e-Akbari. There are two opinions regarding the origin of the Huyas in Assam. According to one, which is most prevalent in Western Assam, they came from Gowra in accordance with the terms of the peace agreement made between Gowreshwar Dharmanarayan and the Kamadeshwar Durlabh Narayan in the beginning of the 14th century. The Kamada king established them at a place called Lengamaguri, situated to the east of Hazu and south of the river Barnadi. Later on, five more caste family, Huya families joined them to raise their strength to 12. This constitutes the Barafuya or 12 original Huya families in Assam. The Huyas could not stay long at Lengamaguri because of the inroads of the Bhutias, and later they settled down at Bardua in Nagaon district. The other opinion makes them descendant of Samudra, the minister of the king Arimatra. It states that Lakshmi, the granddaughter of Samudra, had two sons, Santanu and Samanta. Santanu was a Vaishnava and Samanta a Shakta. Both had 12 sons each. The sons of the elder were called Bor Barafuyas and those of the younger Horu Barafuya. Santanu and Samanta quarreled after the death of their mother. Santanu then migrated to Nagaon and Samanta remained in his original place, which he named after his mother, Lakshmipur. But none of the opinion is acceptable. Although the first one is based on facts, it would be a mistake to suppose that Huyaship in Assam originated only from the immigrant Kayasthas, Kayastha families mentioned above. The institution is much older than the mentioned incident. This is evident from the Rotkusi grant of Purushottam Das dated 1329 AD. Here Purushottam Das had mentioned that he had 1,000 swordsmen. Again, he had mentioned that his father Jayadeva and his grandfather Vasudeva were feudal lords under the Kamata kings. Again, Kamadeshwar Durlabh Narayan recovered his kingdom with the help of the Phuyas. Phuyas first came into prominence in Eastern Assam following the extinction of the Palus in the middle of the 12th century, and in Western Assam probably a century or even less than a century later. Further, Sir Jadunath Sarkar mentioned that Hizamuddin Iwas reduced some Phuyas to submission when he invaded Kamrupa in 1227 AD. It shows that the institution of the Phuyas was old and indigenous in nature. All the same, their descendant from Samudra and the legend connected with it appear to be a fiction and have no genuine foundation. The study of the administrative history of ancient and medieval Assam shows that the institution of the Phuyas had no outside origin. It is observed that land grants were made to officials in lieu of cash salaries. Though such grants were usually made for a period, but in practice, hereditary possession continued owing to the practice of hereditary succession of offices. The same was the case with the feudatories as well. The system being such that with the weakening of the central authority, the feudatories became independent as well as the officers and powerful landlords. The main source of income was the revenue paid by the cultivators. In order to facilitate the assessment of their income of a particular area, they grouped the villages together in units of 12 or less than 12. Each of these units was called sakal and placed under an officer called Phuya. If the unit consisted of 12 villages, the officer in charge was called Barophuya, and if less than 12, he was called Sotophuya, Horuphuya, or simply Phuya. The Phuyas found it easy to set aside the authority of their masters when they grew weak and acted like kings. Some of them adopted titles like Raja, Sutaraja, Gomati, Kayasthas, Samaspati, and so on. Each Phuya was independent within his own domain, but they used to stand united against a common enemy. As the central authority was almost non-existent in Eastern Assam, in between the fall of the Palus and the extension of the Ahom power, the Phuyas acted like independent chiefs till they were subjugated by the Ahoms in the early part of the 16th century. The Phuyas made valuable contributions to Assamese culture and civilization. Shankardeva, the great religious reformer of Assam, was also originally a Phuya. The Vaishnava literature speak highly of their proficiency in the field of learning as well as of their military skills. Many of them were also reputed scholars, whereas others were traders and advanced agriculturists. The Ahom king adopted some elements of Phuya culture to their own. The Phuyas also made a noteworthy contribution towards the expansion of the new Vaishnavite movement in Assam. Again, it was they who had successfully resisted the early Muslim invasion into the northeast. So, in the medieval period of Assam, the Phuyas had played a very important role in Assam, and the Phuyas of Assam and Bengal had some similarities, though the Muslim Phuya is not available in Assam.